Hello and welcome to Tech. I am Ahmad Adnan and in this video we are going to discuss about what is CTE in SQL Server. It's a part 1 and it's going to be a series for that. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. CTE stands for Common Table Expression. Specifies a temporary named result set known as Common Table Expression, CTE. This is derived from a simple query and defined within the execution scope of a single select, insert, update, delete, or merge statement. This class can also be used in a create view statement as a part of its defining select statement. A common table expression can include reference to itself. This is referred to as a recursive common table expression. This we can discuss on the later video. There are two types of CTE. One is a common table expression, regular one, and another is a recursive common table expression. CTE can be used as a temporary table inside the query. We can reuse the query results. Now let's go into the practical how it actually works. So I opened the SQL Server Management Studio. And in this, I have connected to AdventureWorks database, which you can download it from Microsoft website. Here, this is a basic query. I have taken it here from the sales order header. Select sales person ID, sales order ID, and the year of the order as a sales year from the sales order header table, where person ID is not equal to null. So if I run this query, execute, then I get this result of 3800 rows. So salesperson ID, sales order ID, and then the sales year. This is a regular query. Now, if you want to make it to a CTE, to create a CTE, you just need to add these two lines. To define a CTE, you have to start with this one, with, and then the CTE name, user defined name, and then as open bracket and the query which we have just seen before, and then the close bracket. So now this became a temporary table inside this query, and if you want to get the data of this query, of this table, so we can use the select store from CT1, which we have given the name it CT1. So if I select from here to this and execute, I'm going to get the same result. This is how we can able to define the CTE. Now, as I said, it works as a temporary table and we can also reuse it. Here, I have taken the same query with CTE1 as define the select statement, and here define the outer query referencing the CTE name. So here select A dot person ID. So this is the CTE1 I defined as A, and then the count of sales order ID as a total sales and the sales year. I have used a group by functions as well, and then I ordered by sales order person ID and then the sales year. If I select here the all statement and execute, I'm going to get the result of the sales person ID and per person how much the sales count and in the year 2014. So I have filtered the year 2014 here. So it just returns the 2014. So we can start with CT as and then open bracket, and we can define our query here and then the close bracket, and after that we can reuse the result of this CT. So these are you can able to define the CTE in SQL Server, and which is the most important thing for the developer to reuse the result set of this query. And in the next part of the videos of this series, we are going to go in depth of the CTE and how we can better use of this functionality in SQL Server. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.